The Honourable Member for Cape Breton Centre, Whitney Pier.
Mr. Speaker, my question is for the Minister of Labour, Skills and Immigration. The Office of the Ombudsman conducted an investigation of the island employment and made a number of recommendations. One recommendation to the department was to assess whether any of the findings required a forensic audit. The minister has said in response to my questions, these findings were very serious. Mr. Speaker, will the minister agree to conduct the forensic audit which the union representing the workers has called for?
The Honourable Minister of Labour, Skills and Immigration.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you to the member opposite for the important question. So the recommendations in the Ombudsman report, the majority of them have taken place, and some of them are which are still in the works. It's really important that, yes, the significant findings in the Ombudsman report indicated mishandlings of funds, and that's what we made our decision on, was exactly that. To the employees, I really want to make sure that they know that we're committed to finding another service provider and as quickly as possible. The decisions around the organization were not actually government decisions that were made, but again, just want to know that the recommendations that were given were implemented, and some of them which are still in the works.
The Honourable Member for Cape Breton Centre, Whitney Pier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I can only assume that that's a no to the forensic audit. Mr. Speaker, the Ombudsman did not recommend these 30 employees be laid off. That was a decision made by the government. And it is the minister who is now encouraging the workers of Island Employment to apply for advertised jobs with lesser pay and benefits. Meanwhile, the board, management, and those responsible for the government oversight are being left off the hook. Mr. Speaker, will the minister explain why she chose to terminate the agreement with Island Employment rather than addressing the concerns as outlined in the Ombudsman's recommendations? Thank you.
The Honourable Minister of Labour, Skills and Immigration.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you to the member opposite for the important question. We know that the employees, this decision really impacted them, and we know that, and we just want them to know that we see them, and we know that the services that they were providing were really great, and that's another reason why we are working so hard to make sure that another service provider is in place. One thing that's really important is that the organization's decision to close was not a government decision. We are working really hard to make sure that there is a new service provider in place. There's an interim provider right now that the employees can go and find jobs and apply right now. But again, jobs will be available under that new service provider, and we just want the employees to know that we know that they were doing good work. Our decision was around the handling of the funds. Sure.